scenario you might be familiar with. Let's say you have an existing application and it's a few years old, so it was built using CDTs and DSEs. But you still want to get the benefits of Appian's data fabric and features that come with synced record types, such as record level security, record type relationships, and data fabric insights. In this video, I'll share three tips for how you can seamlessly use Appian's data fabric in your existing apps without going through an entire app refactor. This video is brought to you by Academy Online and the Appian Community YouTube channel. For more learning resources, check out the description below and don't forget to like and subscribe. Let's start with understanding Appian's data fabric. Data fabric is a data architecture approach that allows you to unify, secure, and optimize data that's spread across your enterprise, while keeping your data where it is so you can build modern, data-driven applications more quickly. Appian's data fabric is powered by record types with data sync enabled, or synced record types. Synced record types give you features that make app building faster and your data more valuable, like record type relationships, custom record fields, and record level security. So let's talk about how you can use data fabric in existing apps that were built without synced record types. Tip number one, create synced record types to use specific features like Process HQ. Process HQ is a workspace where business users can gain visibility into their enterprise data and processes. It includes two capabilities, Data Fabric Insights and Process Insights. In Data Fabric Insights, business users can build reports and dashboards using the enterprise data they have access to. The data sets they see in Process HQ are based on synced record types. So if you want to get the benefit of quick end-user reporting, you can simply create synced record type versions of your data using your existing data source. Then just configure security to determine who can see what data and make the record types available in Process HQ. Your data will be ready for business users to explore and build meaningful reports and dashboards with. You can also use record events to keep track of who takes action when. When you create a synced record type, configure record events with new tables or existing ones. Then you can update process models to capture events. You'll be able to use the event history component in UIs to see activity logs and use the event data in Process Insights to analyze your processes and uncover potential improvements and savings. Tip number two, use synced record types for new development. If you're going to make additions to an app that's already been built with CDTs and DSEs, instead of continuing with this approach, use this as an opportunity to build out your data fabric. For example, if you're adding a new dashboard in your application, you can create new synced record types to use in the interfaces. This way, you'll be able to use record type relationships to quickly build charts and grids that display data from multiple sources, add custom record fields to quickly aggregate or clean your data, and use record level security to ensure the right people see the right data. And as you continue to build out your data fabric over time, you'll get compounding benefits. The next app or enhancement you make will be even easier to build with this foundation. The more data you bring into Appian, the more value you'll get out of it. Tip number three, find targeted places in your app to rework using synced record types. Incorporating data fabric doesn't have to impact every part of your application. You can use synced record types in containerized places that only need focused testing to boost performance. One example of a place to start is with data coming from an integration or web service call. If you're calling an external API on your UI, you are likely doing so at the cost of a speedy user experience. First, create a new synced record type that uses a web service as its source. Then, upgrade the expression rules to use more efficient queries with synced record types. Or if you find slow queries or interfaces, say a landing page that is loading a lot of data, it could be an opportunity to use synced record types. Especially if the landing page gets a lot of traffic, the performance benefits you'd get from new synced record types would greatly improve the user experience, making reworking this interface worth it. Keep in mind though, that when you do this refactoring, you should create new synced record types using the same data, rather than upgrading existing record types to enable data sync. So as you continue to work with Appian's data fabric, don't forget that there are easy wins you can get by incorporating synced record types into existing applications. Create synced record types to use specific features like process HQ, use them for new development, and find targeted places in your app to rework. For more videos like this one and to keep learning about the latest Appian features, like, subscribe, and turn on notifications. And for more resources to learn Appian, check us out at academy.appian.com.